The Bible says the shouts of joy and victory shall not depart from the tent of the righteous. Listen, God sent me for your sake. I want your heart to be open. There is no reason, no reason. When God wants to help you, he reduces the distance between you and a vessel he has anointed. Are you ready? That one shout, you will shout it just once. And every yoke, every devil, please make sure you bring them out very quickly. Prayer department, help ushers, please. We can't depend on, if you're in prayer department here, you are released, you are anointed to go and help do the work with ushers too. In the name that is above all names, and by the power that raised Jesus Christ from the dead, I decree right now that everyone under the sound of my voice, God, you know how many people came here with oppressions in their families. You know how many people you sent here by your spirit whose destinies would otherwise not be opened. You know how many people who have been asking for answers. In the name of Jesus, as your people shout, everything that is not of God, ordinances, curses, yokes, plagues upon plagues, let it give way now. At the count of three, you're going to shout Jesus. Are you ready? One, two, three, shout Jesus. Break, break, chains, break, break, chains, break. In the name of Jesus, altars be destroyed, be set on fire. Over families, be set on fire. Over destinies, be set on fire. Over careers, be set on fire. At the shout of Jesus, be set on fire. Bring them out. In Jesus' name we pray. In Jesus' name we pray. The Lord is ministering to me. You have applied for jobs. There is nowhere you have not gone to. You have submitted CVs. But sometimes you even go for the first phase of the interview. But after that, everywhere is shut. In the name of Jesus, I declare the power stopping you, cutting favor from you. As I speak right now, in the name of Jesus, that power is destroyed now. 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 The Lord is opening my eyes and I'm seeing the map and I'm seeing Nasarawa State. There's someone, you are from Nasarawa State. The plague of witchcraft has trapped you. Where are you from? Where is this lady from? Nasarawa State. Stand up. We hail you, Most High. Please give her the mic. My sister, where are you from?
I'm from Nasarawa State.
Nasarawa State?
Yes, I came from Lagos.
But you are from Nasarawa State?
Yes, sir.
Nasarawa State?
Yes, sir.
This is what I'm seeing.
Yeah.
From Nasarawa State. Not necessarily just her. When he says to one, he says to all. Nasarawa State. I'm seeing a mighty deliverance that is about to happen to families connected to Nasarawa State. I want to pray, anyone who is from that state and has been trapped by witchcraft, that you don't go forward, horns that have kept you down so that your head is not lifted. In the name of Jesus, I declare right now, fire from heaven, let it rest upon you. Fire from heaven, let it rest upon you. My glory, the lifter up of my head. But thou, O Lord, art a shield for me. My glory, you lift my head. But thou, O Lord, art a shield for me. You're my glory, the help that lady. Lifter up of my head. You're my glory. My glory, the lifter up of my head. is a police officer. A police officer. I'm seeing a woman, police, you are wearing red, a police officer. You're my glory. Confirm, please verify. Is she a police officer? There should be someone talking to them. Huh? Where?
What's that?
You know, sometimes people see these things and think that you are just, not everybody is playing games. So let me tell you. Listen to me. Not everybody is playing games. There are people who have been forged from the fires of affliction. Before you vet people, I want you to research on their journey with God. Not everybody is a joker. Do you understand? So I need to say this now, because I know that sometimes they think everybody prophesying is just a joker. No. 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 What, where, when, what's your name?
Garros, Bishus.
You're a police officer?
Yes, sir.
Where?
Force headquarters.
Where's force headquarters?
Louis Edith.
You're all police officers. My sister, something is about to happen to you that will make you shed the tears of joy. I don't know you all, but you will see the wonder-working power of God. Who is Regina? I'm hearing a name, Regina. Regina, if it's not your name, don't come out here and say, I just came to be blessed. Please, let's be obedient. Obedience is better than sacrifice. If it's not your name, please, you will still receive. But if it's not your name, don't tell lies. We're in the house of God. Madam, is your name Regina? Huh? Come again? You're a police officer. No problem. Come. Regina. I'm hearing Regina. Your name is Regina? Where are you coming from, madam?
Je parle français. I'm speaking
okay,
French.
Somebody, she needs an interpreter. Where are French people? Please, quickly. Don't worry. Let her be comfortable. Pierre, please, let's have a French person. She can speak the French and then we'll have someone interpret. Let me be ministering to this one first while she can be patient. Your name is?
Gina.
Regina. Yes. My dear, shout Jesus as loud as you can.
Jesus!
In the name of Jesus Christ, I pray for you. Everything that would have killed you in August, by the power that raised Christ from the dead, these dreams you are having of seeing dead bodies, I stand in the name of Jesus right now. Let the spirit of death help her. I cast that spirit out of you in the name of Jesus Christ. Suleiman. I'm hearing a name, Suleiman. Suleiman. I'm hearing a name, Suleiman. What is your name? Suleiman.
Yes, sir.
From where?
From Ogun State, sir.
Come again?
Ogun State, sir.
You are Suleiman from Ogun State?
Yes, sir.
Is that where you are from?
Yes, sir.
Your parents named you Suleiman?
Yes, sir.
You are from Ogun State?
Yes, I was born a Muslim, sir.
Oh, you were born a Muslim?
Yes, sir.
I see. The call of God is upon your life. Are you hearing me? There is a mighty hand of God that is upon your life. He's going to raise you to be a mighty vessel. Go and read Jeremiah chapter 1 from verse 5 to 12. Jeremiah chapter 1, verse 5 to 12 is a mandate God is giving you. He will train you all, but you will become a mighty vessel in his hand. Do you believe that?
Yes, sir.
Police officer, my sister, I'm seeing you climb a ladder in the spirit. This lady, what did you say your name is?
Garros Beatrice.
Garros Beatrice. Where
yes,
are you from?
Plateau State.
You are from Plateau State?
Yes, sir.
In the name of Jesus, I declare over you, as Amen. God has revealed to me, what he says to one, he says to all. Everyone interested in climbing that ladder, because the Bible says the path of the just is as a shining light. As God is speaking to her, this officer, I decree and declare, whatever is stopping you from rising, we bury it now. We bury it now. We bury it now. My dear, I release grace upon you in the mighty name of Jesus. Find favor with your superiors in the name of Jesus Christ. The officers, I pray for you by the power that raised Christ from the dead, and in the name of Jesus Christ, I decree and declare, you will not die in service. The Lord will preserve you. This woman placing her hand on her head, I rebuke the spirit of death. You, I curse it now from you. In the name of Jesus Christ, I curse it now from you. Because I'm seeing this woman go somewhere, not returning back again. Hallelujah. There is a gentleman here. You work in a tech company. You work in a tech company. All the people who are involved in apps and all of that, I want to pray for you. Because I'm seeing you. You don't have to come up, but I'm seeing a gentleman. I'm seeing you leave to the US. And God is connecting you with a big tech firm. And he will lift you there. And because of that, I'm seeing you lift your loved ones. This is a gentleman, you work in a tech firm. Wherever you are, in the name of Jesus, the God who reveals is also the God who performs. I declare, let there be a performance to this prophetic word. Let there be a performance to this prophetic word. In the name of Jesus. I'm seeing a court case over land. This is what I'm seeing. I can imagine that with the crowds here, the probability is high that there's some kind of land thing, but this is a very huge property and there is a court case over it. This is a family property and there is a court case over it. And the Lord is telling me to declare mercy so that it will not be taken from that family. In the name of Jesus Christ, I decree by the power that raised Christ from the dead, because you have come here tonight, may God show you mercy. 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 The Lord is speaking to me. Are you ready to interpret? Okay, go ahead. So let her speak and then tell her to speak and then you interpret. Let's.
Okay, il faut parler maintenant. Il faut parler.
Ah oui, je comprends.
So she's called Regina.
Okay.
And we are from Congo Brazzaville.
Oh, you are her husband.
Yes,
you are most welcome.
We are
God
from
bless you.
Congo Brazzaville.
Oh, you are from Congo Brazzaville.
Yes,
I see.
Yeah.
I'm going to pray for you. Okay. What do you do?
I work for the World Food Program. I'm the deputy country director.
Okay.
And I work with Pastor Timothy Adeyinka.
Ah, I see. Yeah. I see. Yeah. I'm going to pray for you and your wife, Regina. Yeah. The month of September. It's a strange month of breakthrough for both of you. Please go on. Can you tell her? Let her. Is she hearing me? I need her to believe. Tell her that I said so. You don't have to say it with a mic. It's your wife. So talk to her. In the name of Jesus, for you and for her, the month of September, from September 15th upwards, my God is going to open strange doors for you. And I prophesy by the power of the Holy Spirit. You came from Congo, Brazzaville. Listen, my friend, you will return back here and you will testify, you and your wife. In the name of Jesus, let strange doors be open for you. In the mighty name of Jesus, let strange doors be open for you. In the mighty name of Jesus. I'm about to pray, but the Lord is showing me someone. Your mother has cancer. We're going to pray, but there's someone, your mother has cancer. Your mother has cancer. Father, in the name of Jesus, whether mama is here or connected online, I'll soon be praying for the sick now. You see, this cancer thing here is a killer spirit. That thing is not sickness, oh, it's a demon sent from hell. Because once it comes upon you, the first thing it does is to stop the progress of your life. The second thing it does is to devour your finances and that of all those around you, then finally take your life. Is that sickness? That's not sickness. That is the character of Satan. It steals, it kills and destroys. Whatever steals, kills and destroys is a thief, and it's not a thing, it's a person. I use the opportunity to pray for everyone suffering the plague of cancer. He said, with long life will I satisfy you and show you my salvation. I'm praying right now. Lung cancer, breast cancer, prostate, all kinds of demonic cancers, by the power that raised Christ from the dead, Hence, God has revealed it. I declare healing now. Hence, God has revealed it. I declare healing now. In the name of Jesus. I'm seeing a lab coat and a stethoscope. And the Lord is saying I should pray for all the medical people. I would usually not do this, but if you are a doctor here, please come out. Something is about to happen in the world of doctors. If you are not a doctor and you come here, we'll send you back, please. You are a doctor. Doctor, listen to instructions. Doctor, please come. Let's celebrate them as they come. You are a doctor, medical doctor. You can stand. You don't have to kneel. Hallelujah. I'm not a prophet of doom, and I'm careful when I say things like this, but as I'm standing right now, I'm seeing coffins and I'm seeing lab coats on them. I don't know what it is, but this is doctors just dying like this. Not doctors, medical doctors. And the Lord is saying to pray for them. Let me give 1 minute. Please hurry up. We have a lot to do. If you're a doctor, please, you should be healthy and agile. If there are doctors outside, those following online, you are a doctor, please connect. I want to pray for you. There are arrows that fly by day. There are noisome pestilences. It is not unusual for Satan to want to strike you because you are the ones who midwife the healing power of Jesus. Doctors, please come. Not doctors in training, doctors. If you are still in medical school, God bless you, but we pray that you will become a doctor one day. But doctors practicing, doctors, please. I'm seeing a coffin and I'm seeing a lab coat on it. Lab coats. This is like a doctor passing. This is not just a Koinonia thing. Oh, I'm praying for the body of Christ. Let me tell you the truth. The purpose of the prophetic, if done with integrity, is not to create fear. And it's not to deviate people from the patterns of Christ. Prophecy exhorts. Prophecy comforts. Prophecy gives direction. Are we together? Doctors. Let's stretch our hands towards them in 1 minute. Pray like you are praying for your sister. Pray like you are praying for your brother. Doctors will not die. Whatever this vision means, one thing we know is that there is a name that is above all names, and no doctor here is appointed unto death, not by the same sicknesses they are treating, and not by a demonic plague that will move like a virus and kill them. Go ahead and pray. Koinonia, pray. We're responsible ministry. We stretch our hands over these doctors as a point of contact to all other doctors and medical practitioners. Every plague that hell is preparing to kill and destroy doctors, by the power that raised Christ from the dead, we avert it now. We avert it now. We avert it now. We avert it now. They are instruments of God's mercy. God will preserve them as such. They are instruments of God's grace. God will preserve them as such. They are instruments of longevity. God will preserve them as such. In the name of Jesus Christ, I decree and declare, using you as a point of contact to those who are falling online and the many medical practitioners we have, by the power that raised Christ from the dead, while you minister to us, by priesthood I speak, live. Live and not die. I speak the blessing of Reuben upon you. It says, let Reuben live and not die. And let his men not be few. I say to you again, let Reuben live and not die. And let his men not be few. One more time, let Reuben live and not die. And let his men not be few. In Jesus' name we pray. God bless you. Please return back rejoicing. 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 Hallelujah. Return back rejoicing. I struggle to share this vision but my conscience will not allow me if I don't share it. We need to pray. Yesterday, while I was praying, I saw a vision, and I saw that the devil wants to bring back something in this nation that once happened, the era of bomb blast. I saw this in my vision, and the Lord, it came as if it was something physical that I was there, and the Lord said I should pray. This is not to scare you. Again, prophecy does not bring fear. Are we together now? Yes. The dominion power of the word is greater than anything we see, and the purpose of revelation is to bring salvation and redemption. But I saw this, that there is a plot again to revive this thing about bomb blasts again. The church has the authority to stop this devil's thing. Are we together? The nations are crossed, and the nation is already going through too much. Every bloodthirsty spirit, hear what I'm saying. It was here I stood last year and I preached, I shall not want. I told you that I had a vision, and in that vision that I saw, that there was going to be a lot of economic hardship. And even as a ministry, we said we'll take responsibility. And thankfully, we're able to partner with CSS Farm to be able to do something small. I'm not somebody who comes on air and wastes my time. I respect God, but I also respect myself. Are we together? The teaching ministry is enough for me. The miracle ministry is enough for me. But if I come out here to tell you God said, then it's not only because I saw, it's because He's impressed it upon my spirit. Are we together? You have invested your trust and your loyalty. I will not come and play games, not at this point of my life in ministry. Why is God revealing this? So that we'll pray. I'm going to pray for the sick, but we are going to pray. Pray so that it will not be where you are there. Remember how Mordecai warned Esther. He said, don't you think the plot of Haman is just for all of us? God has brought you for such a time as this. Number one, we are going to pray. This nation is God's nation. For the sake of the elect, God will preserve His name. Number two, we are going to pray. Anybody working with elemental forces to resurrect something we have casted out of this nation, we are going to ask the earth to open and swallow them. You don't like that prayer, but keep quiet while I do the praying in the name of Jesus. Are we together? And then number three, we are going to pray for the armed forces, defense, police, civil defense, for wisdom, courage, and grace. You may not know how these people labor until you have a husband or a brother or a child, that while they are sending them to go and fight, you don't even know whether they will return back. Are we together? Can we lend our voices to pray? In the name of Jesus, open your mouth and pray. Blood thirsty spirits over the soul of Nigeria. Blood thirsty spirits over the soul of this nation, to resurrect mayhem, to resurrect evil, to resurrect death. In the name of Jesus Christ, whether as sacrifices or demonic orchestrations, we call upon God, who is a jealous warrior. Arise for your namesake. God reveals to redeem. Arise for your namesake. In the name of Jesus, arise for your namesake. By the power that raised Christ from the dead, we avert evil. We avert evil. We avert evil. We avert evil in the north, in the south, the east, the west of Nigeria. We avert evil in Abuja here, the FCT. Our going out and coming in is blessed. In the name of Jesus, we pray for the law enforcement agencies. Grace, integrity of service. In the name of Jesus, that perpetrators of mayhem will be apprehended and brought to justice. We empower them by prophecy. We empower them with wisdom. We empower them with grace. In the mighty name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Use this opportunity to declare the covering of the blood over yourself and your loved ones. Mention them by name. My child will not die. My mother will not die. If they leave my house in the morning, they will return in the night. If they leave my house in the morning, they return in the night. If I take a flight, it will not crash. If I go by road, there is no accident. In the name of Jesus, blood-thirsty spirits walking through evil men, walking through wicked men, it will not come near my dwelling. Not the arrows that fly by day, not the noisome pestilences, not the destructions that waste in noonday. In Jesus' name, your business can only thrive when there is peace. Your business can only thrive when there is peace. Are we together? You can only go to school when there is peace. Satan wants to fight the soul of this nation, but the devil is defeated. In the name of Jesus Christ. There are still witnesses and envoys, preservers of God's purposes. In the name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God. Hallelujah.
The Lord is placing a very strange grace for finances. Listen to me. Please, I want you to believe it. There is a grace for finances, and it's coming on many people. I'm not asking you what you are doing. I'm not asking you what you know. I'm telling you what God is doing. I stand by the God of heaven, and I declare, Father, the men and women that must enter into this dimension, as you are showing me, at the count of three, may that grace rest upon you. 1, 2, 3. Take that grace now. Take that grace now. Take that grace now. A strange grace for abundance. Receive supply from heaven. Supply by the Spirit. Let things walk in a way that will surprise you. I command things to walk in a way that will marvel you. Mighty God, a few minutes, we are going to pray for the sick now. Now please listen, I'm only going to do this for this overflow and overflow one. That's not to mean I'm neglecting the remaining. It's just a revelation that God is giving me. There are two angels standing by my left and my right. And every time I see this, God wants me to move. Listen, hear me. Except God is not God, when I pass any road where you are, anything that does not name the name of the Christ, and any dimension that is not of God in your life, it must give way. Now, I'll only do this for this and overflow one. Afterwards, we are going to pray for the sick. Please, I want you to just believe. I don't know why God does these things, but I want you to believe that He is mighty and that He will glorify Himself. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, glorify yourself. Change everything that needs to be changed. Many of you will be receiving impartations that will shift you to dimensions. I want you to believe it. I will pray, not everywhere, but there are a few people. I'm seeing this happen by the Spirit. Hali Shalatos Pragados Kreketevara. I shift you. in the spirit. Every limitation that does not name the name of Christ, I'm praying, mantle, anointing by the spirit coming on people right now. Let that presence of God shift you to dimension in the name of Jesus. Dimension. I'm seeing a chain around here. I break that chain now. I'm seeing a chain around here. Let that chain be broken now. Let that chain be broken now. Let that chain be broken now. Break now. Break now. Break now. Break now. Chains be broken now. In the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus Christ. Madam, God is turning your life around. Where are you coming from? Kaduna State. In the name of Jesus. Break now. In the name of Jesus. Be free now from everything that is not of God. Be free now. Something is breaking here. Something is breaking here. Something is breaking here. Parushalikatos. I break it, take it, take it, take it. I break it now. I break it now. I break it now. I break it now. By the Spirit of the Living God. I break it now. Mama, I break it now. I break it now. Sensing an evil spirit just around here. I come against you now. I take authority over that influence. You must go now. Go now. Go now. Go now. Go now. Overflow one, lift your voice and pray in the spirit. Now listen. Please. Be your brother's keeper. You don't have to touch me. Please, be your brother's keeper so you don't enjoy yourself. But as I stand here, everything that is not of God is about to give way right now. Thank you, Jesus. Go now. Let it go now. Let it go now. Let it go now. All that I come against you now. Release them now. Release them now. Breaking over someone's family. Be broken now. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Be broken now. Be broken now. Beauty and glory to your life. In the name of Jesus. Now watch this. Listen. Hold on, please. Hold on, please. I'm standing here and I'm seeing. Who is Rebecca? Rebecca, they call you Becky. Rebecca, just not inside. Here you ask, what's your name? Rebecca. Don't worry, it's okay. What's your name? Don't just come out if, in the name of Jesus Christ, come. I end oppression now over your life and your family. Oh, you, my dear, your name is Rebecca. Where are you from? You are from, are you from Makoni? Benway State. In the name of Jesus. I keep seeing this spirit every time I pray for people. That thing they call Aleku, A-L something K-U. In the name of Jesus, I curse that spirit by the God of heaven. If there is anyone under the sound of my voice who is a victim of that spirit, you are from that region, I stand by the God of heaven. Let it come to an end now. Help them, please. Let it come to an end now. In the name of Jesus. Hold on, please. Right here, there is a gentleman who will be mightily used by God. I just saw a strong mantle from my head resting on someone. I stretched my hands. Lord, I don't know where they are. Let that grace come on you now. Strange mantle, prayer fire, word fire, illumination in the spirit. Receive that grace now. Receive that grace now. Receive that grace now. I'm standing here and I'm seeing a family with a yoke of marital delay. I'm seeing something that looks like an arrow just coming from heaven. Right now, let deliverance come now. Let it come now. I'm still moving. The hand of God is coming to people right now. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Please, you don't have to touch me. In the name of Jesus. Right here. Financial stagnation comes to an end. An anointing is coming on someone for your family. Financial stagnation. Let it be over now. My dear, be free now. Out! Now! Someone here, the power of God is coming on that person. Be free now! Free from everything that is not of God. New dimension. I've seen an anointing here. New dimension. The old story must leave you. That's what God is saying. I'm prophesying to someone here. The old story must leave you. The old is gone so that the new will come. In the name of Jesus Christ. Where is the woman? Wait, hold on. I held someone's hand now, holding a photo of a sick patient. Where is she? Come. Who is this? Where is he? He's in China. What's wrong with him? He's depressed now. If I don't pray for him, I'm seeing him inside a coffin. In the name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the Living God, let there be deliverance for him now. What's his name? Ibrahim. This is not only something affecting him. This is something that is influencing the entire family. But I stand by the God of heaven and I set you free. In the name of Jesus, be completely free. And I speak to him, Ibrahim, may the power of God touch you and perfect you now and perfect you forever. In the name of Jesus Christ. I want to pray for the sick. My friend, this man looking at me, come. Where are you coming from? Huh? You are from Kogi State. What do you do? Are you a man of God? You came here trusting God for fresh fire. Come. You are about to receive it because I'm seeing you from Kogi State. You, where is your church? Look at me, sir. Where you have a church? You are under a church. A time will come, God will give you your own work. Now God is preparing you. Be faithful. You will go, but now is not the time. You leave now, you will suffer for nothing. Are you hearing what I'm saying? Don't let sincere people come and push you out of the will of God. But surely a time is coming and you will walk in very strange dimensions of the anointing. Father, I lay my hands upon this man. Let his dealings with the Spirit progress. In the name of Jesus. Not only an impartation, a dealing that produces real power in the Spirit. In the name of Jesus, may that grace rest upon you by the power of the Holy Spirit. In the name of Jesus Christ. This lady with green, this lady, you, come. The Lord is about to turn your life around in a way that will surprise you. Two things will happen to you. Number one, I'm seeing restoration. God is saying, I should tell you, he's bringing restoration. Number two, I'm seeing the gift of men. Please do listen to my message. Help them on the gift of men. God is bringing people strangely to lift you. I lay my hands upon you and I pray, may this grace be effectual. Carry that grace right now. And you will start having visions. Visions. God is going to start giving you dreams and he will start giving you visions. In the name of Jesus. This is very strange what I'm seeing. Except that I saw it, I will not say it. Stop running away from the call. You are a man of God's wife. Now, I'm saying what does not make sense. stop running from the call. You are the wife of a man of God, a minister of the gospel. The Lord will bring performance to his word. This thing I tell you is a strange mystery, the way God works. But in the name of Jesus, I place the word of God upon that prophecy. It's time for you to not fight the will of God. It's time for you to relinquish your own will in the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. We are going to pray just one prayer point. The Lord is asking me. Immediately we do that, we'll pray for the sick and we'll start submitting our request. Where is that young lady that came out with one mama while I was praying for her? There's a young lady that was wearing glasses. I don't know if you are here. You are the one. What do you do? You are going to be very wealthy. Come. Are you a lawyer? Huh? Is this your mother? Where are you coming from, madam? Okay, you are the Rivers woman. This lady you see is going to be extremely wealthy. Because I'm seeing you a lawyer. And you are going to, I don't know what area of law you are going to specialize, but I'm seeing you sitting with so many business people. This is a lot of business people. Signing contracts, helping people to process a lot of things. Millions, huh? That's what?
That's where she is right now. Doing some things abroad.
She's what?
That's what she's doing right now, where she works.
That's what she's doing now.
Right now, where she works.
Because I'm seeing God will just cause them to like her. It's not every man that is a foolish and a stupid man. There are people who are out to genuinely bless.
Yes,
and I pray for your daughter and I connect her by the Spirit.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus,
amen.
She will find these people.
Amen.
And in the name of Jesus, she will shift her to another dimension.
Amen.
Mama, God is saying I should tell you, forgive. Does it make sense to you?
My husband also is a lawyer. But
your husband is a lawyer?
Yes.
What was the issue? Nothing is happening. Don't worry, ma. Do you know why you fell under the anointing? You fell on behalf of all the troubles in your... It wasn't just your personal falling alone. There are times that you fall representing all of these troubles. Because this is not what I'm even saying. God is saying I should tell you to forgive. Forgiveness. Now, it doesn't make sense. And God has not given me an interpretation. But let me tell you this. You see, look up. The average person seated here has been hurt by someone. Whether friends, are we together? Uncles, relatives, people you trusted and they betrayed you. Let me tell you something about unforgiveness. Unforgiveness is a terrible spirit. It's one of the master secrets to delay. Unforgiveness. It will keep you in one place forever. You are there angry and annoyed, and most of what you'll be angry about is legitimate. However, you see, forgiveness is a type of giving. Understand this. Forgiveness is still the giving grace that helps men to forgive. The only thing with forgiveness is that you give in advance. Are we together? The highest form of forgiveness is tolerance. Where you know it will happen again. And you build a system around it to not hurt you. We live in a society that is so hurt conscious. This one hurt me. This one did this. There are too many things that can create offense. The Bible says, in nothing should you be offended. It's a choice. Mama, in the name of Jesus, please don't cry. I don't know what it is and why you are crying. But my dear, comfort your mother after the prayer, eh? In the name of Jesus, what is before you is greater than anything that has caused you pain. And in the name of Jesus, forgive. In the name of Jesus, forgive. I also pray for someone here. Do you know there are many couples that have not been able to forgive one another in marriages? It can last for 10 years, 20 years, same room, same bed, but that bitterness, especially for the men. We don't know that this might be the secret. The Bible says, for dishonoring your wife, the consequence is that your heavens will be closed. It's not a lie. That's why you see men struggle, and simple things become hard because of the propensity for bitterness. Make up your mind in this miracle service that you will let go and not only forgive but tolerate. I wish I can tell you there are some things your loved ones are doing that they will never do again, but they will do it. Every time a door is about to open here, offense comes. It's a choice. I will not be offended. Are we together? Father, we pray for our daddy in the name of Jesus. The kind of miracle that God will do in the life of this man, let it be so powerful that everybody around will know that this is the doing of the Lord. I decree it and I establish it in the name of Jesus Christ. There is a gentleman here. We are going to pray goodness. You see how time just runs. There is a gentleman here. You are a member of Mountain of Fire. Where are you? Mountain of Fire. You are a serious brother. Mountain of Fire. Now, please, I'm not just saying you attend. Don't listen to instructions, please. Right? MFM, my friend. You are serious. You came from where?
MFM Kano.
MFM Kano. How about you? MFM Calabar. How about you?
Lagos.
I want to pray. I'm not saying if you are from MFM, just come out like that. There are particular people. It doesn't matter what denomination you are from. Once you are here, this is a universal, this is a master key. It will complement on what every grace and every man and woman of God is doing. But I want to pray for you. My friend, I'm first going to pray for you. Where are you from?
I'm from Akwa Ibom State.
There is serious witchcraft sitting on your desk.
Yes,
I hope
sir.
You are not embarrassed.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
You need help. You are prayed. Stand up, please. You are a prayer warrior. You can pray. You can do fasting. Sometimes you just need a grace to help you. You hear what I tell you? I'm going to pray for you. If I don't pray for you, I'm seeing the spirit of death start sweeping people in your family like that, like play, until it starts killing people. But let me tell you, don't despise yourself. You need a lot of mentorship, but you are going to be a
that truly enters you. That door is open unto you. That means what is possible for Sam may not be possible for Folake. Are you seeing that? The difference is that the light you are seeing is not sufficient to open that door. But the Bible says, I have set before you an open door. No man can shut it. Hallelujah. Prayer point number two. We are going to pray for understanding. It's not enough to have insight. Listen. Take this prayer point seriously. You're going to say, Lord, all the principles that are responsible for the various areas of lifting, show me how they work. Show me how they work. Lift your voice and pray. Show me the keys of wealth, oh God. Show me how to operate it. Show me the keys of the anointing. Show me how to access the fountains of spiritual power. Show me the keys of holiness. Show me the keys of deliverance. Show me the keys that will make me command power even in my family. Make sure you are praying, understanding, and with all your getting, get understanding. Know how it works. It's not enough to have keys. Know how to apply it for maximum results. Pray. Rekoto sekete lebaka. Show me, oh God, the key. Show me how to operate it. The Bible says they know not, neither do they understand. And so they grope in darkness, and the earth is out of course. Rekete ba. Show me. I tell you, many of you, as you are praying right now, God will begin to give you understanding. Show me the mystery behind the operations of wealth. Show me the mystery behind the operations of grace. Show me the mystery. What makes the Spirit of God become so real to a man? Show me the secret of church growth. The secret of increase. The secret of influence. The secret of leadership. The secret of power. The secret of abundance.
show me, oh God, the mystery of doing business in deep waters of the spirit. Show me, teach me, oh God. Hallelujah. 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 We are going to pray. Isaiah 48, verse 17. Can we project that? Let's see. I hope I'm right. Everybody read it. You are going to pray and say, Lord, this year, you are going to direct me and my life will experience increase only. He said, I am the Lord that teacheth thee to profit. I can teach you how to do it and lead you in the way that you should go. Lift your voice and pray. Rekoto sekata. Divine direction. Let the stars shine. Let the morning stars shine, oh God. Lead me to the place of destiny. Lead me to the next level. I'm tired of confusion. Show me, oh God. Show me, oh God. Show me, oh God. Go ahead and pray. Maritally, give me direction, oh God. I cry for direction. Financially, give me direction, oh God. Academically, lead me, oh God. Let the star arise and let me follow the star. In terms of my career, lead me, oh God. Rekoto seketa. Lead me, show me in my ministry. Show me, oh God. Show me, give me direction. Pray. Illumination, my life. I am the Lord that teacheth thee to profit and lead you. Show me, show me, show me, oh God, where you want me to be, what you want me to do, who you want me to connect with. Show me, oh God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Next prayer point, you're going to pray and say, Lord, let a new dimension of unction, let a new dimension of power mantle my life this year. Lord, I want to move in the anointing in a level of grace. He said, and he measured 1,000 cubits. Lift your voice and pray. 1,000 cubits, and it was to my ankle. For no man can do this thing except God be with him. Pray. My horn shall thou exalt like the horn of a unicorn, and you will anoint me with fresh oil, because thou hast loved righteousness and hate wickedness. Therefore God, even thy God, had anointed you. Thou anointed my head with oil. My cup runneth over. Pray. Lord, I'm moving in the anointing. Pray. This is the year. You do business with the anointing. You do your job with the anointing. You minister with the anointing. You conduct your activities under the influence of the heavy unction. He says you have an anointing from the Holy One and you know all things. Pray, pray. Worship team, pray. We minister with the anointing. Media, pray. The anointing takes us to another level. Prayer band, pray. We are praying with the anointing. Rekoto seketa. Koinonia, pray. This is our year of the anointing. Inside and outside, no matter how far you are, let that anointing take you. Walking signs, wonders, miracles. Let the sick be healed through your life. Let breakthroughs, let chains be broken. Let lives be delivered and restored. Let sinners be saved. Let the anointing make you a savior. Let the anointing make you a deliverer. Hallelujah. 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 Two more prayer points and we're done. Please, everybody, participate. We're establishing the prophetic word right now. Hallelujah. Listen. This next prayer point is very important. You're going to pray. Listen. The Bible says, arise. It says shine. And the Bible says in Daniel, I believe 12 or 22 or so, I can't remember, verse 3. It says, and they that be wise shall shine like the firmaments of the heaven. And they that turn many to righteousness as the stars even forevermore. Listen, you are going to pray. It's not a selfish prayer. Don't pray for your neighbor. You are praying for yourself. You're going to say, Lord, display, show what you have put in me this year. My God, let men see the hand of God. Go ahead and pray. Unveil it. Unlock it, oh God. In 2014, my year of life, I manifest. I am a city to my family, in my department, in my faculty, in my place of work, in my place of business. Let there be a showing forth. Show forth, oh God. Show forth prosperity through me. Show forth a healthy Christian through me. Show forth holiness through me. Show forth breakthrough through me. Let me become a portrait, an epistle. Show forth. Manifest, oh God. Manifest, oh God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Listen. Listen. There are many of us. This is the year your destiny helpers are supposed to see you. Hold on. You are going to pray that veil that has covered that grace of God in you, that unction, the Bible says there is this treasure. There are many of you, you have been relegated to the background. This is the year. This is the year. Say, Lord, arise in me. Come on, pray. Lord, arise. Let men see you through me. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. If you're looking for a vessel, I'm available. Let me be an epitome of the anointing, an epitome of wisdom, an epitome of wealth and prosperity, an epitome of leadership, an epitome of power, an epitome of revelation. Pray, pray. Make sure you are praying. Hallelujah. Listen, brothers and sisters, this prayer is so powerful. There are many of you that have business ideas, but nobody knows. It's an idea that can bless you and stop hunger in your family. But nobody knows. When light comes, it exposes darkness. Let me show you a scripture. Galatians 1. Galatians 1. Let's just look at that one scripture. Galatians 1. Verse 23 and 24. Galatians 1. God wants to walk through you, not for pride and arrogance. Are you getting me? I'm not talking of the kind of lifting and influence that takes you to hell. But they had heard only that he which persecuted us in time past now preacheth faith, which once he destroyed. 24. Everybody read it. 1, 2, read. And what? How did they glorify God? That means when they saw what God did with my life, and they said, Lord, is this what you meant when you said you can bless people? Is this what you meant when you said you can use people? Are you ready to pray this prayer again? Lift up your voice. Say, Lord, I'm available. I'm available. Shekatabakabayadaba. Make a spectacle out of my life. Lord, make a spectacle out of Koinonia in 2014. Dr. Sasso, let there be a display of the glory. Let the nation see we are a city on a hill. They glorified God in me. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You're going to pray for yourself now and your family. And say, Lord, it's also my year of dominion. Listen, you're going to pray. And say, Lord, I don't just want to chorus this. It must be dominion. Dominion means absolute control. Are you listening to me? Therefore, pray that for you and your family, whatever has mocked God to your face, this is the year it must come under your feet. Lift your voice and pray. Dominion, oh God. Kingdom authority. Pray. Is it finance? Is it a terminal disease? Is it lack of breakthrough? Is it sin? Your family members are not safe. Pray. Get angry in your spirit. Those outside, are you praying? Those outside, are you praying? Reporto secretary, total dominion. No more fibroid this year. No more getting sick and getting well. No. Pray. No more prosperity today and poverty tomorrow. You will not be on fire today and backslide tomorrow. No. The part of the church is as a shining light. It shines brighter, brighter. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Now you are going to pray for Koinonia. We are going to say, Lord, take us to another level. Take us to another level of impact, another level of prosperity. Pair yourselves into three. Pair yourselves into three. Those who are lying down or praying, just leave them. Those who cannot stand, just leave them. I want us to pray seriously. Hallelujah. You're going to say, Lord, lift us up. We're not just asking for fame, we're asking for impact, salvation, transformation. Come on, lift your hands and pray. Let this place become Bethel, the place of bread. Bethel, the place of bread. If you love this ministry, pray. The ministry is not Joshua Selman, the ministry is you. Lord, a harvest of souls, a harvest of souls, a harvest of souls, a harvest of souls. Transformation, oh God. Drunkards will come here and become apostles. Prostitutes will come and become prophets. Your word is mighty and it prevails in our midst. Your word is mighty and it prevails in our midst. This year we experience character, we experience excellence at another dimension. We experience wealth and prosperity as a ministry at another dimension. Revival, oh God, let there be a fire of revival that will spark from here and spread to the nation, and spread to cities, and spread to campuses, and spread, spread. Pray for our Friday program, pray for the counseling, pray for all our external ministrations. Pray for the miracle services. Lord, let every service be a miracle service. Beginning from this one, let every service be a miracle service. Let this place become a solution center. Let this place become a place of authentic miracles, authentic signs, wonders, breakthroughs, restoration. Let the sick come and be healed. Let blind eyes be healed. Let incurable diseases be cured. Let there be a mantle of healing, of breakthrough, of prosperity. May men come here and have their spiritual life fired up. Fired up. Passion, oh God. Passion, oh God, for the things of the Spirit. This is a place where we infect people with hunger, with passion, with fire for the things of the kingdom. Pray. This is a place of love, no discrimination, no discrimination. This is a place of love. Everyone is special. Everyone is honored. We will not teach error in this place. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Now listen to me. We're almost rounding up. Listen, please. Inside and outside, everybody listen. Please. Hallelujah. I want you to know that in 2014, you are first an ambassador of heaven. Second, you are an ambassador of this ministry. Are you listening to me? That the gentleman who came and testified that he went to preach. I'm not the kind of people that does God of this, God of that. I don't have any. We teach kingdom. We give you a kingdom mindset. Are you listening to me? But because you belong to this structure, you must. There are certain. We have a culture. Are you listening to me? We have a culture. You can come as you are, but you do not remain as you are. Something should happen and change you. Hallelujah. We have core values in this place. Our first core value is love. That's why you don't see anybody. We don't say come and sit down because your father is the president or your father is the governor. We don't want to know. Where God grants us opportunity to know, we salute you and then that's all. Hallelujah. So you must contribute in letting the love of God. The first thing that should be seen in your life is love. Not power, love. You can be anointed and not walk in love. That means this is the year that you maintain your words. The Bible says, let your words be seasoned with salt, that it may minister grace. Make up your mind this year. No gossiping about people. No backbiting. No carrying news left, right, and center. Your job is to love. If somebody does something, go and talk to him, not about him. Hallelujah. Are you listening to me? The love of God. He says, by this shall all men know that ye are my disciples. Not when you raise the dead. When you have love one for another. Hallelujah. There is no doubt that you step on one another's toes. So you must, it must be a predefined thing in your heart that you're going to walk in love. Because the Bible says there remaineth these three, faith, hope, and love. He said the greatest is love. Hallelujah. So this is the spirit and the culture that you must have. Your conversations must speak love. When you are angry, keep quiet rather than saying nonsense. Hallelujah. The Bible says, he that does not err, if a man err not in words, that man is a perfect man, able to bridle his tongue. Don't just say anything anyhow. Number two, character. Everybody say character. There are many Christian circles where the men of God are just thinking of power. Let me tell you, anointing can take you far, but it's character that will sustain you. Hallelujah. That's the reason why you can see a ministry rise up. They are anointed and then they fall like a leaf because they lack the character. This must be the year you will contend to manifest a Christ-like life. You don't live a life, a dirty, polluted life somewhere, and then the only place they just see you in church and people say, even you? Character. It must not be something you fake. It must be a revelation. And that's the ministry of the Holy Spirit. Character. The entire scope of whatever character means to you. When you do something wrong, tell people I'm sorry. Don't say, Debbie, I'm older than you. When I graduated, you just entered secondary school. No. Have respect for people. Don't come with village and tribal and cultural mindsets. I'm from a royal family. In our village, I must sit down before others. Sit. Keep your, you have been called out of every tribe and tongue. Are you getting my point? Listen, let me tell you something. Many of us here are young people. And we are, this is a training ground. We are training you not just to be anointed people, but to be leaders. So that when you go somewhere, you can speak aright. You have a culture. Don't speak anyhow. Hallelujah. Remember, you are representing Christ. Especially for as many of us outside. Speak like a believer. Always know that the Holy Spirit is in you. Number three, the anointing. You must contend and let the anointing find expression in your life. It's not enough for you to just come and be blessed. You are an extension of the ministry. Our job here is to equip you and release you with the power of the Holy Spirit. You should go back to your hostels, go back to your workplaces and legislate on behalf of the kingdom. Not to be jumping and shouting and saying, I'm anointed, let everybody in this office bow to me. Demonstrate it. When there is breakthrough, when there is wisdom, when there is character. Hallelujah. Number four, this year, you must adopt excellence as a lifestyle. Everybody say excellence. We must keep contending. It's one of the things I told the leaders. And we'll still talk more during our retreat. Hallelujah. Excellence. Excellence is not about an expensive life. Excellence is an organized life. Are you following me now? Excellence from your personal hygiene to everything about your life. There are some of us who are born again, but we are so dirty. You are so dirty. This is the one weakness. This is where the devil is cheating you. This year you must repent. Are you hearing what I'm saying? Don't just laugh. Excellence. Hallelujah. Your words. You must pray this year. Those dirty, godless things that keep putting satanic dictions, you must get them out of your life because you are a man on a mission. Don't say anything and say, this is the slang invoked. This is a kingdom. This is a culture. Hallelujah. Jadel sang and said, this is my culture. You have a culture. Don't go ahead. They see you in the market and you are speaking as if you are never born again. Even in your joke the word, speak the word. I'm saying this to you because many of you are emotional now. Immediately you step out of here, you almost want to do something. Just remember, don't do things because of men. Do it because God Almighty is watching you. But much more than that, that He desires to use you. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Think before you talk. Don't just say everything. Even what does not concern you. This is how many people put themselves into trouble. you go and shoot your mouth into people's businesses and enter their trouble too. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. It's very, very important. So let this year be different. Say, I'm a light. Say it, I'm a light. No offense, no unforgiveness, no, God forbid, no over my dead body. All those demonic languages, pack them and throw them outside. This is a new season. Even when, see, people will mock you, whether in your workplace or your department. Let them mock you until they see what you become. They are only mocking you because they are intimidated by the light that is shining. Hallelujah. When somebody talks against you, bless you. When they think you are coming to defraud them, you say, bless you. I heard what you said. I'm not happy, but I love you. I belong to a government. Are you following me now? Not the ear of saying, let me meet with him and you will know. I asked you from the beginning, can two walk together? So are you ready? See, this is it. If you are ready to walk with God, you will see his hand. But if you don't see the hand of God this year, it's not God's fault. For me, I told God, I said, Lord, whatever it takes, I'm ready to walk with you. Hallelujah. Let me pray for you now. I want you to believe it. I want you to believe it. I told God, I said, Lord, I'm more committed than ever before to serve your people. And I'm saying it before everyone. My primary assignment, listen, my primary assignment is you. You. Whenever you talk of Koinonia, think of yourself. Don't think of Joshua Selman or the leaders in the ministry. No. Hallelujah. Without you, we have no ministry. Hallelujah. And I pray to God, I said, Lord, I'm ready to make sure that all that you have put in me, let your people receive it. Hallelujah. Before we go and we are traveling around and blessing other people, and then you are hearing of the mighty things that God is doing with us in other places, and you are wondering, oh Lord, I'm so close and I'm not receiving anything. I told God, I said, Lord, if I never go for any ministration, this is why we are opening up the doors for counseling and all of these avenues. We are restructuring the leadership to allow us to have access. In fact, I was talking with somebody and my heart was bleeding. I said, this year I will make sure I have time for the workers. There are many times that many of you want to see me, but because of how busy we are, I told myself, I said, look, not only will I be a leader or have an apostolic ministry, this year I want to be a father. I don't want people sitting down and dying and then we are there. Let me tell you, even if the whole Nigeria is talking about us and you are not getting blessed, we have failed. This is what people like Joshua Suleiman will call public success and private failure. Are you getting my point? Even if they say this ministry is not being impactful, if you are being blessed, we are fulfilled. Because you are our primary assignment. And so I'm telling you again, on behalf of myself and the leadership of this ministry, we are committed. We will keep fasting. We will keep praying until you become all that God has destined for you to be. Even before anybody. So please and please, I want you to relax and know that you are not all of you. I'm speaking to everybody, even those outside. We don't have second class citizens in Koinonia. Are you listening to me? We don't have favorites. No. We love people based on our assignment. It will have to make us interact with more people than others. But let me tell you something. Everybody in this ministry has a right to be heard, has a right to see me. I'm not one Superman in myself somewhere. Are you following me now? Because I know that I need to say this, because many of you may have been feeling, I know that there are some of you, I remember one day, a lady tried calling me and I just woke up in the night and I decided that the next day I was going to call her. When I picked, I called her. This lady shouted, she could not believe she dropped the phone. You understand? She was surprised. Apostles, I think she was telling her mother. For many of you, that's nice. You feel like a celebrity based on God's standard. That is very bad of a leader. I can't promise seeing everybody where you want, Don't wake me when I'm sleeping because I made a commitment to help. I still have my sense arise. I won't pick your call. Praise God. But then I'm saying there is a system. Hallelujah. By the grace of God, I've made up my mind that we will have special counseling sessions for the workers. Special, just the workers, one by one by one. One by one. Everybody, pray with you. If you're not a worker, these are some of the things you are missing. Praise God. Hallelujah. There are privileges that our leaders must receive. For instance, the heads of departments cannot book for counseling. It's an insult. Why will my leaders book for counseling to come and see me? You see that? So don't be offended if you have to book for counseling. I promise you, we'll stay as long as possible to meet your needs. Are you following me now? And some of your family members, if you try to call me and I don't pick, by God's grace, we are going to announce, we are strategizing. In fact, there are a few new departments we are creating to make sure that we meet the needs of everybody, that even if it's a text you send, you will be responded to. So just cooperate with us. We are improving. This year will be better than last year, in Jesus' name. Lift your hands. Let me pray for you. You too, you must be ready to cooperate. Look at me. I've said my own part. What I'm committed to do to you, you must be committed. Your own part of commitment is don't frustrate our sacrifice. Receive what you are teaching. Let it not enter one ear and go out there. Put it to work. Hallelujah. And be evangelist. Say, do the work of an evangelist. Invite people, not just people who are not serious, people who really, 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 really need help and need God. Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you for 2014. Please make sure you lift your hands, especially those outside and watching. I bless you in the name of Jesus. I bless you with the blessings of heaven. I bless you with the presence of God. I bless you with the anointing of the Holy Spirit. I pray for you that even as you've begun in this place, you will sustain this place to the end of the year. I rebuke death. We will not mourn the death of anybody this year. In the name of Jesus Christ, therefore, any covenant that anyone has with death, anywhere they have said they must bury you this year, we cancel that report now. In the name of Jesus Christ, I command that the scepter of dominion come upon your hand. That as you leave this place, you will begin to reproduce what you are seeing. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, let the doors of wealth be open unto you. Let the doors of influence be open unto you. I pray that this year, your prayer life will enter another dimension. Your word life will enter another dimension. I pray that the spirit of true holiness will come upon you this year. In the name of Jesus Christ. And I pray that the Lord will make your feet like hind feet, that you will run and overtake everyone that has gone ahead of you. I pray for you that before you pray this year, before you even make mention of it, may the Lord answer you. May the Lord hear you in the day of trouble. I pray for your businesses. I command them to prosper. I command them to flourish. In the name of Jesus, may the Lord grant you the desires of your heart. I pray that the anointings and the graces God has put upon this ministry, let them find expression in your life. Everywhere you go this year, you are favored. You are favored, favored with God, favored with men. In the name of Jesus, all those who have planned to put you down, they are the ones who will celebrate your lifting this year. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, I command that you are preserved. You enjoy the ministry of angels. And I pray for you that this gift of God that is in you, that not even you will be able to hide it this year. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, let those who need what you carry look for you. You will not look for them this year. I compel them to look for you. In the name of Jesus Christ, may the mighty hand of God go with you. I pray for you wisdom. Exams is starting when? On Monday. Lift your hands. I pray. Whether you're writing exams or not, lift your hands. Whether you're a student or not, you can connect for people. It's a corporate anointing here. I pray for you, especially for final year students. Any power that says you must come back to this school, we cancel it right now. For those of you who need the mercy of God to graduate, we command that mercy right now. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, every lecturer that has vowed to keep you must let you go this time around. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, I pray for you supernatural intelligence. Let a mantle of intelligence come upon you. I prophesy upon you, pursue, overtake, recover all. Everything, though some of you are trusting God to enter 2-2, to enter 2-1, and this is the last exam that will determine it. I pray like Samson, may the hand of God come upon you and may you do wonders. I bless your exams. This is the best exam you have ever written. In the name of Jesus, your papers will not be missing. In the name of Jesus. And for those still trusting God for admission, it's not over. I hope you know. I prophesy that the God, on the third day, he said, if any man thirst, let him come. There are some of you who have concluded you did not see your name. I pray that may the Lord God, the one who is never too late, visit you in this 2014. In the name of Jesus Christ, let the beauty and the glory of God arise in you. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Now, I want to invite all those very quickly, a few minutes and we'll be out. Please keep standing. I know you've tried. Keep standing, please. Let's honor those who are coming. There are many of you outside and a number of you inside who have never made a decision for Jesus Christ. Some of you, this is your first night. Some of you are the students who got admission. You just came excited. Please listen. Jesus said, come unto me, all ye that are weary and heavy laden, and I will give you rest. It's my honor to invite you tonight to tell you that you can stop the struggle. There is a better life. There is a higher life. He said, I am come that ye may have life and have it more abundantly. Therefore, right now, I want to invite as many who want to give their hearts to the Lord. You are saying, help me tonight. I want to be reconnected to God. Or some of you who have made that decision before, but you know that you have derailed and you want the